Sky News Business and CEO of Your Empire Buyers. Just thought I'd start a bit of a daily market update. There's a lot of things going on in the world now. And just like we used to do on Sky News, is quite often we don't want to conform with the media and just go with whatever the conversation that people want to hear. It's actually, what do I actually think about the market? What am I doing about it? And what are my contrarian thoughts on potentially what you could do? Now, look, the big thing is now is the property market. Look, it's hard to see what's going on, but we can see what's going on around the rest of the world. If we look at the stock market, we can see how volatile that is. It's literally up and down all the time. And there's so many different stories about how bad it could be or how good it could be. The Prime Minister's come out and it's the hoarders. The hoarders are the absolute nightmare, the toilet. The toilet paper has taken us worldwide news. And this is the problem. It's just so irrational. As soon as one person does it and then they run out of toilet paper, then everyone else thinks, well, I don't believe in it, I don't think there's a problem, but I still need my toilet paper, so I'm still going to go and do it. And so we almost need to get into wartime rationing to realise that people, it's going to be okay. And look, I understand a lot of people are in isolation at the moment. We're kind of semi-on, semi-off at the moment. One kid at school, one back home, my wife and I in and out at times. But it's that bad. There is still food in the supermarkets. There's fresh food. Sure, it's not going to last you for months, but if they can keep supplying it, it's still going to go on. Our government isn't going to let us starve. There hasn't been stories around starving. And so for the people that are in the property market, people for investments, the great thing is it takes such a long time to sell a property, and there's always a 6-week settlement. Stops people from doing it overnight, because otherwise our $1 million homes would be 500 and they'd be bouncing back, and that doesn't help anyone. It doesn't help the banks, it doesn't help the government. It really is a great thing that it takes so long to transact a property, because then it brings some stability. So look, for I think there's two camps here. There's people that are obviously really, really worried, and they're unsure about what's going to go on. They think they might be losing their jobs, or maybe they've already lost their jobs. They're ill, they're stuck at home, and they've got some problems and the rest of it. From being in the media and listening to, most of the time I'd rather listen to the government than I would, I don't always want to listen to the government, but I think they're going to be slightly better than Facebook, which I understand I'm on at the moment. But there's so many experts out there. You listen to the Prime Minister and the government as to what's actually going on. But there's so much stimulus about. Both here and globally are talking about changing from P&I to interest only. They're talking about dropping rates. So for those people with a mortgage, if you lose your job, you're not going to be thrown out of your house straight away. Sure, there may be black marks, but I think even the black marks may be erased over this period. Is the bank's not going to try and force people out of their homes because they can't physically deal with it. Like I think the first few pages of my book says is, the government and the banks have got a vested interest in keeping the property market, because the whole world is built up on lending money to properties. Obviously, the stock market as well, they need to control that. People can buy honestly. So, look, I'm not anyone necessarily to listen to, but please, we just need to try and calm down and stop making rational decisions. Now, on the other side, we've probably had our best week ever. So we've got clients that have been, I guess, waiting to buy property for a long time. We had staff meetings a couple of weeks ago to say, look, we're finding it really hard to buy. People are paying 5 or 10% more. And so as a business, we're doing it tough, because we've got clients that want to buy, but they can't buy because we always want to buy on valuation. We never want to overpay for a property. And it makes our life really, really hard. So half the people come off and decided to put things on hold after a 5 or 6 month. $3-4 million mortgage in this, because there's no guarantee of the job. So I understand for those people, and that's the right decision. Other people that are looking more around the 750, a million, 1-250, then some of them have said, look, we're in our own businesses. We don't know if we're going to need to keep that cash for our businesses to prop it up for working capital. Again, completely understand that as well. And look, there's some other people that say, look, I've been waiting to get into a home for ages. Every time I've been trying to bid two million, it's gone up to 2.1 or 2.2. Is now is the window that you might be able to get in. But the problem is the greed might say suddenly they want it for 1.8, 1.9 now. And my message is if you've been waiting 6 months to get it for 2 million, you've been missing out, you can now get it for 2 million, just buy it. Don't be greedy, because this is what happened in 2017 to 19. Everyone was trying to bottom the market and no one could do it. And they're trying to go and say, oh, that's going to be cheaper in 3 months. And it's exactly the same conversation happening now. But then it didn't. It suddenly turned. And my thought is there's going to be a whole bunch of people that are going to miss it again. So we're doing deals. So we've done 3 off-market deals this week. We did the last one last night, which I haven't posted up yet. And we're trying to do 2 more deals at the same time, which will probably flow into next week. So there's people out there that are trying to get deals. They're not getting them half price. They're not stealing from the unfortunate, but they're just giving genuine offers to say, look, sure, last week it was worth a million. You wanted 1.1, it's not happening, but maybe I'll give you a million or maybe 950, but I can transact straight away, and whatever it is you want to do with the money, you can do that. So look, there's 2 camps, and I'll give more information over the next, or every day over the next couple of months to try and help people and give you stuff like that. But from both sides, if you're doing it tough, just wait till it actually happens. And even if you lose your job or you're stuck inside or whatever, most of the time, in my experience, it's not as bad as everyone thinks. And if you're on the other and you've got to go, you want to go and invest, again, that might be a short time because things may get over. No one knows. So no matter who you follow on social media or the government, no one knows. So you can't say, no, this guy says it's going to be going for 2 years. There is no guarantees. And at the same time is you've just got to make the most of the moment. So anyway, that's my honest opinion. If you want to leave me some messages, more than happy to try and pick up or just go to our website.com.au as well. Next week, we're going to try and set Lewis up with some strategy time. So if you want a quick 10 minutes, you're having a bit of a panic or you've got a burning question that I'm not answering, then we'll try and set that up that you can get automatic chats with Lewis. And look, if it's seriously dire, then I'll try and free up some time as well. But look, thanks for joining me. Feel free to pass this word, but definitely I'll be giving you thing rather than what we're or pushing us into a certain point of view. So stay safe and hope all goes well.